Hello class, today we'll do experiment on lead acid cell and nickel cadmium cell. Objective: to perform charging and discharging of lead acid cell, nickel cadmium cell. Apparatus used: lead acid cell, nickel cadmium cell, hydrometer and digital multimeter. Theory: lead acid cell. The charging and discharging of the cell can be represented by a single reversible equation given here. If you see the equation, left side when the cell is fully charged and right side of the arrow mark is cell will completely discharge. So this is the reversible equation and cell is fully charged and cell is fully discharged. So in left side, positive plate lead dioxide, 2 times of sulfuric acid, that is electrolyte, and the negative plate is lead. Similarly, in the right side of the equation, both the positive plate and negative plate, lead sulfate and 2 times of water. So when the cell is completely charged, the equation will be lead dioxide plus 2 times of sulfuric acid plus lead. When cell is going to discharge, so when the cell is completely discharged, the equation will be lead sulfate 2 times water plus lead sulfate. Similarly, for nickel cadmium cell, the chemical changes are more or less similar to those taking place in nickel iron cell. The electrolyte is split up to positive cations and negative OH ions. The chemical reaction can be represented by the following reversible equation. Here also, left side of the equation of the arrow mark, when cell is completely charged, and the right side of the equation when the cell is completely discharged. So when the cell is completely charged, the equation will be in positive plate nickel hydroxide and the electrolyte is potassium hydroxide and the negative plate is cadmium. Similarly, when the cell is completely discharged, the positive plate and negative plate becomes nickel hydroxide and cadmium hydroxide, and the electrolyte remains potassium hydroxide. So equation will be NiOH4 plus KOH plus Cd NiOH2 plus KOH plus CdOH2. Procedure for charging: connect the cell to charging board, positive terminal to the positive and negative to the negative of the supply. Adjust the charging current 10% of the normal lead. Switch on the supply. Check the specific gravity of electrolyte in case of lead acid cell. Their consecutive readings should be same after hourly readings. It should be 1.265 to 1.275 at 80 degree Fahrenheit. Check the voltage of the cell. It should be not more than 2.2 volt in lead acid cell. The cell voltage should be more than 1.2 volt for nickel cadmium cell. Disconnect the cell. Discharging procedure: connect the cell to the discharging board, positive to positive terminal and negative to negative terminal of the supply. Adjust the discharging current 1/10 of the ampere hour ratings or AH ratings. Check the duration of the discharge. Note down the duration of the discharge. Voltage should not fall below 1 volt. This is the block diagram for charging circuit. Here you need step down transformer, then rectifier, current limit limiter or current limiting resistance, then charging circuit. Obviously, you have to mention or you have to monitor the battery voltage and the cell or battery. There should be overcharge cut-off circuit. Similarly, for here, this circuit for discharging or discharging of the cell. So left side, the cell is connected positive terminal to positive terminal and negative terminal to negative terminal. And voltage meter is connected across the cell, and you have to require a fuse also so that you can limit the emitter, and this is, and the load or the variable resistance is connected. You have to vary the resistance as per 1/10 of AH ratings. So objection table. For lead acid cell, you have to note down the cell voltage during charging and during discharging and time in hours. You have to take down the readings in hourly basis. Nickel cadmium cell. You have to note down the cell voltage during charging and during discharging, and you have to note down the times in hours. You have to take 5 readings. Result. By the observation table, we can see the charging and discharging of nickel cadmium cell as well as lead acid cell. For charging the circuit, you have taken a 6 volt 3 cell battery. And the charging unit, this is the 2 terminals for charging unit and 2 voltmeter for the charging circuit and the cell voltage. You get 2 voltmeter and ammeter are taken for this one. And to limit the current as per the instruction of cell, maximum charging current that can flow through the cell will be around 0.25 ampere. So for that, we will connect a rheostat or resistance, variable resistance in series with the circuit so that it will limit the current to around 0.25. For that, we connect a resistance that is 50 ohms. So 6.6 divided by 50, that is equals to Y, that is comes around 0.13. So that is enough to control the series current through the circuit. We will start the connecting the circuit. So this is, we are connecting for the charging unit, voltmeter for charging circuit. See, this voltmeter is connected for the charging circuit. So it shows around 7.1 volt and the cell voltage is 5.8, and this, you have to charge this 5.8 to maximum voltage around 6.6 volt. So we'll connect the circuit.
So this resistance is connected in series with the charging element, and it is going to the cell of the positive. So this positive of the cell is connected to the resistance and is coming back to the cell. Again, the negative part is directly connected to cell like this way. So we'll switch on both cell and charging unit. So we have to put a ammeter across so that we'll see the charging current also. See, the ammeter shows 0.03 ampere. So now the charging current is taking 0.16, and we have to record the time, how much time it needs to charge to 6.6 volt. Now it is showing 5.9. The cell should be charged from 5.9 volt to 6.6 volt. So this is our the charging unit's voltage showing 6.9 volt, and the cell voltage showing 6.4 volt. So gradually it will be increased to 6.6 volt, and same time we will record the time, how much time it will take to charge to 6.6 volt. After 1 hour 20 minutes, the cell voltage is around 6.3 and the current is taking almost 0. So this is the way how the battery will be charged from discharge to 5.9 to 6.2 volt or 6.3 volt. So now we'll construct the discharging circuit. See, the cell voltage showing 6.1 or 6.0, and for discharging one tenth of the maximum current, that is 4, it's a cell you are using 4 A's. So maximum current that can flow during discharge, that is 0.4 ampere. For that only you will add a current limiting resistance or variable resistance, so that we will limit the current to 0.4 ampere. From the supply only we will take it just at this point. First, we'll connect the ammeter so that we can adjust the resistance to 0.4 ampere. We'll switch on the circuit. See, current is taking 0.1 ampere. We'll adjust to 0.4, one tenth of the cell current, maximum current. So battery, you are taking 4 A's battery. Our voltage showing 5.7 volt, current showing 0.4 ampere, and this much of current is flowing through the circuit, or you can say this much of current is, this much of power is giving from, you are taking from the cell. So how much current for the, how much current or time is taking for discharging the cell, we have to note down. So this is the voltage is on load. So if you remove the this resistance, you can see the voltage is showing 6.0. Previously it was 6.1, now it's 6.0 because 1.1 volt discharge due to the 0.4 ampere current is flowing. Similarly, see this, this current is, it's a fixed current is flowing through the circuit. That means the circuit, the cell is taking, giving the full maximum current or and continuous current or continuous power. So this way, it will take long time to discharge the cell. So after 30 minutes or after 1 hour, we will show the actual the condition of the discharging procedure or actual how much current that can discharge the cell. Will after 30 minutes we will show. Or this process is going on. After 1 hour of discharging, still the voltage is 4.8 and current is flowing 0.32. When cell is completely charged, that time terminal voltage or EMF shows 6.1. Now the terminal voltage dropped from 6.1 to 5.8. Still this cell is completely not fully discharged. So after, as per theoretical, you can find out the discharging time. Suppose for example, if you have taken 4 AS cell, so if you will take 1 ampere current from that cell for age, so it will last 4 hours. Similarly, theoretical time you can find out, and as per practical, you can time taken to drop from 6.1 to 5.8 is taken 1 hour. Similarly, you can match the time and you can say if the cell is serviceable or not. Thank you for watching the video.